day 12 of the holiday. I'm here in Costa Maya, Mexico, is how they pronounce it, Mexico. And today, I'm going to be taking a coach. I'm going to be going about an hour's drive through swamps to get to a jungle that contains a secret Mayan temple. I'm going to try and find out all the secrets that it holds about the astrology and all of that behind it, and what the significance is. Of the Caribbean, part 4.
Lucky you were born that far away, so we could both make fun of distance. Lucky that I love a foreign land for the lucky fact of your existence. Baby, I will climb the
Costa Maya, Mexico, which is how you pronounce it in Mexico, and I'm here to find the Mayan temple, which I've actually done behind me. Here's the first one, which has much astrological significance, especially since the Mayan calendar ends next year in 2012. Also, which is quite significant, is today is March 21st, which is the equinox, which means that the day and night are both exactly equal today, and this could have some very strange effects with the astrological style and design of the Mayan pyramids. So let's go take a look.
Mm-hmm.
One thing I should mention is that while the Mexican Aztecs used the solar calendar, the Mayans used the lunar calendar, and they did lots of sacrifices on pyramids, just like this one. So while the Aztecs used to cut out the hearts of the people that they were sacrificing and then throw their bodies down the temple, the Mayans used to chop their heads off and decapitate people and then throw their bodies down. So some minor differences, but maybe slightly nicer, who knows. Let's go and see what else is around. Chichobin, the name of the excavation site, was only discovered in the 1970s. I think it was like 1974 or something. And they've just been doing the excavations. They've only started excavating this area in like 1994, so it's actually quite new, so you never know. So it's only like, what, 15 years old? Who knows what we'll come across. So, I just found out that this morning it was observed that there were two suns that were rising. And it's not because there were two suns, it's because one of them was Venus. And because of today being a special day, if you look at the top there, so those two little things, that's where on today, the first time in many, many years, both the sun and Venus will appear in alignment with that pyramid. Only today, and all the people that work here are very excited about it. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be around here because I'm going to be back on the ship by then. But very interesting. Just shows you that how accurate the astrological and architectural engineering was of the Mayans. Incredible. And that's the deal, my dear. I don't know if you could see that, but that was some bats living in a tree. So over here, this area, all of this was burial ground for some Mayan people. And they were buried with like massive jade earrings and bits of like obsidian black kind of volcanic glass jewelry. So it's quite interesting. Take a look. Seems like they were buried into the foundations of the house and into the walls and into the steps. Don't know why, but it just means that they were actually part of that family house or something. The pyramid that we saw earlier, that was an observatory. And that's why it's to do with that sun and Venus thing. Cool, huh? Position. You can't really see it, but it's the hieroglyphics on there that claim that he was very powerful and had a lot of astronomical power. But right now, we're going to go and walk up to the next pyramid, the pyramid of the sun god, or the pyramid of the sun. Take a look at these steps. Oh, And that's just the steps to get ready to get to the pyramid. Let's go. Now you probably saw some of the trees as I'm walking up these steps. You saw some of the trees that were that we passed by. Now, a few hundred years ago, some pirates actually came to this area, but they couldn't find any gold. Couldn't find any gold or anything, but what they did find was some coconut trees. And the wood was so strong, they actually used it to help build their ships. Also, the coconuts, about 300 of the coconuts would be used to make 1 gallon of coconut oil. So that was quite good. Take a look at this view. Temple of the Sun. So I'm gonna try and find out some information about the astronomical significance. Or is it astrological? I'm not sure. Let's find out.
Lucky you were born that far away, so we could both make fun of distance. Lucky that I love a foreign land for the lucky fact of your existence. Maybe I will climb the Andes solely to come with freckles.
I do know. I find out that the Mayans used a lunar calendar. So their calendar had 20 months made up of 13 days each, which meant that they had 260 days in their lunar calendar. But how is that significant to this solar or sun temple? I'm not sure. Let's find out. Look at that. That's a fruit that is edible when it's ripe. However, the sticky part of it is actually used as gum. So you can boil this up and make chewing gum. This is where one of the American dudes came in a few years ago and discovered how to make chewing gum, which is quite cool. I think they actually use this and sap from barks of trees to actually glue the stones together of the temples. There's another one over here. Don't know what this temple is about. It looks interesting though. That according to Mayan calculations, they say that the Earth, like this current cycle of life that we're in, started about 3,114 BC, something like that. And they calculated that the cycle will end next year on December 1st. I've also heard that some temples around Mexico have seen today, on today's date, remember I told you it was the equinox, kind of a shadow of a snake type shadow on their pyramids. What does that mean? I don't know. But it's interesting though.
Lucky factor.
this isn't a pod wall behind me. I think this is a lookout point, so you could see what was going on around them. Wow. I could have just climbed a tree, I guess. Anyway, that's it. I'm heading back to the port. Enough Mayan stuff for today. It's been an interesting and educational experience. Talk to you again in a minute. Bye.
Lucky that my lips not only mumble, this girl kisses like a fountain. Lucky that my breasts are small and humble, so you don't confuse them with mountains. Lucky I have strong words like my mama to run for cover when I need it. And these two eyes that for no other, the day you leave will cry a river. Let on a man, a man. Let on a man, a man. At your feet. I'm at your feet. Whenever, wherever, we're meant to be together. I'll be there and you'll be near. And that's the deal, my dear.
Well, there you have it, another end to another day. So we've seen the mysterious Mayan temples. It's time to relax, enjoy the port a little bit, and then go back to the ship and get ready, because tomorrow we're going to another island, and that's Rotan Bay in Honduras. Until tomorrow, see you there. Bye. Place.